Canva websites just got a whole lot better. You can create professional looking websites and landing pages quickly and easily. And I've partnered with Canva to show you how to create a Canva website, add something cool with Canva code, and I'll even show you how to turn your existing designs into website content. Let's jump in. As a Canva verified expert and super creator of templates for Canva's library, I was recently a speaker at Canva Community Labs in Sydney, where I did something cool and created a Canva website as part of the presentation for the local Sydney Canva lovers. Along with my fellow CVE Rebecca and Yana, community manager from Canva, we did a deep dive into Canva's new features, including websites. I'll walk you through the steps I took to create this website. It was designed for attendees to use to join a private LinkedIn community after the event and to network with other Sydney Canva lovers. We wanted a fun logo and brand to reflect the cool vibe of the community we've built at Canva's Community Labs in Sydney. So I used this fun typeface-based logo, bright colours, and some cheeky mascot elements to get started. Here's the key things I did to make this website using our new brand. I used a Canva website template for inspiration, but it's also easy to create from scratch. I did a little bit of both, so I'll show you how. I set up the brand kit to make the process so much easier and keep everything on brand. I used Canva code to create a cool widget section for the website. And a hot tip, which I'll share at the end, I used existing designs for the website, which made it a whole lot easier. We'll start with templates for inspiration and also how you can start with a blank page. To find website templates, simply enter website into the homepage search bar and you'll get so much inspiration. Now, I've created a landing page in this example, but these websites can be multi-page, which is very cool and a new feature from Canva. As you can see, there's so much inspiration and so many ideas. I've used a couple of templates for inspiration, including this one with the mascots and just the general vibe and layout. But I also really liked this one, which was a template that we had from Canva's design team. So I've used some of the inspiration for fonts and colors from here. Now, before I show you the steps I took, I want to show you something really important, and I'll use this template as an example. If you customize any template in Canva, you'll see that it mainly gives you that single homepage. And as you can see, it's quite editable. Everything's laid out in sections. I can easily change the size of the sections. I can even add a new section. And I can change the order of the sections or click and change the colors. So there's a lot of room for editing these templates. You can add links, buttons, and create a pretty robust single page website, but you can do a whole lot more. You can actually add multiple pages. So let's come in and name our homepage as home. And then we're going to just copy some elements and I'll show you how to add a second page. Let's do the beginnings of an about page for the company. So we're just going to add just a basic banner in there. Then we can name the about page and you could go ahead and add different sections and build it out as a really nice overview of your company. But what I want to show you is how to preview this. Come up to the top, hit preview. And you'll see that you now have navigation buttons for every page of your website. So Canva allows you to build out multi-page websites, which is very, very cool. And of course, you can also choose to start with a blank website, which is partly what I've done in this example. If you've watched this channel or worked with me in your team, you'd know I'm always harping on about brand kits. This is a pro feature of Canva, but I think it's worth it for this alone. It's so important for creating content quickly and easily. Here's an example of some of the elements we added to the brand kit, and it really made it easy to set up this landing page for Sydney Canva lovers. So let's jump in and use the brand kit to get it set up. You can see here we've got the color palette on the left, the logos, the fonts all ready to go. And one really cool thing you can do with brand kits is add your approved photos for your team. In this case, I've added some photos from the previous Canva Community Lab that we could use to showcase the wonderful community of people in Sydney that come along to these labs. So here's a photo that I chose from the previous event just to pull it in and make a cool banner. This will form the first section of our landing page or website. And because I have the brand kit set up, now it's really easy for me to pull in an SVG version of my logo. So we have the red version here, but I'm going to change it and make it a little bit brighter so it stands out against the background. So we're going to turn it into blue. But a hot tip, if you want your logos to be changeable, use SVG format. Now we're just going to simply add another section. We'll make this one pink, and I'm going to shortcut this a little here because I want to focus in on the features of Canva websites versus the whole design process. So let's take a little shortcut.
Narrator, two cups of coffee plus a template, magic right, and the brand kit. She created a Canva website.
When you use a template, it's really easy to switch out the elements, fonts, colors, shapes, and photos. In this case, I used a bit of a mix between two templates, but I like how it's come together overall. But I want to focus in on a couple of features now to help you when you're editing templates. Now, for this website, we're directing people to a social media platform, a LinkedIn group, and I want to add something a little bit more fun to the website. So we're going to use Canva Code to make a cool widget to add into the website homepage. To start, go to the homepage of Canva and look for Canva AI on the side panel. Then I add my detailed prompt. I've added quite a lot of detail, right down to the colors to use to be on brand and the fonts, given a couple of choices. I've also suggested what size it should be. I've also suggested that the quote shouldn't be too long so that they fit quite nicely, and that it should be around community, networking, creativity for small business, and that it should rotate every 10 seconds. So I've given a lot of detail. Let's generate this quote generator and see what happens. All you need to do then is choose code for me and then hit the enter button, the purple button there, to get Canva to go to work. This is truly amazing. Canva is essentially coding from my prompt and will make whatever I ask it to make. Now, these coding sessions are usually pretty quick. It can be anywhere from like a minute to 2 or 3 minutes. I'm going to speed up this video because you don't need to see all the code coming out, but I wanted you to at least see how amazing this is. The technology that we have now and the potential for, you know, teachers and kids in classrooms, someone going to do a prototype for an app to then take to someone to build out the full app, or just to get your idea into reality, is truly, truly phenomenal. So here it is starting to generate some of the quotes. I do recommend you definitely check the output of what you're creating, but most of these quotes look pretty good. Okay, let's speed this up. But just so you know, this took about a minute and 50 seconds all up to generate the code. And it's now given me an example of version one. It looks pretty good. It's in my brand colors, nice quotes. If I want to change anything, I just add the next prompt in the box there and it will do another version. Once I'm happy with it, I just click Use in a Design and it will open it up in a brand new design. Now notice that this is the perfect size to add into a website. So all I need to do is copy it. Then I come into my website design and click add a section, and I can use these arrows on the left to toggle up and down. I'm going to just move it up a little bit and keep it near the bottom of the design. And all I have to do is right click and hit paste and my widget will be added. I can check that it works, look at the progress bar and make sure it turns over every 10 seconds, watch it through to see if the quotes are okay. That's very important. And it's looking great. I'm sure you can agree that Canva Code is just amazing and you're only limited by your imagination. And just a reminder to always check the output of Canva Code. In this case, it was an embellished quote from Albert Einstein. It should be creativity is intelligence having fun. So I just went back in and asked it to do a second generation of the quote widget and just made note that this was an incorrect quote. So it wasn't included in the second attempt. So just be sure to check. You might get some wonky output on occasion. But overall, it's a great feature. Okay, we're almost ready to wrap up our website design, but I wanted to just show you a couple of bonus features, including using your existing designs in the website so you don't have to always rely on templates. You might have other content that you can use. So let's take a look at a couple of final bonus tips for creating Canva website. My first tip is to easily add links to your website. So here's one of the sections on the website, and we have a button. You can use shapes, or there'll be buttons usually included in most of the templates. This one was on the template that I used. So we just click in and add a link to that button. Now, in this case, I was sending them to our LinkedIn group for the Sydney Canva lovers, so everyone at the community lab could join that group. But you can also, you know, send people out to your social media sites or any call to action that you have for your website. Another tip is that you can turn any design into a website. So take your presentation, like in this example here, it's a presentation format with pages. You can take social media posts, videos, or documents and turn them into a website just using the publish as website function. I'll show you how I published my finished website in a moment, but first another tip about any content that you want to add to your website. As I said, you can take any design you currently have and convert it into a website ready piece of content. This is a LinkedIn banner that I liked and wanted to add to the bottom of my website. So I can just come up here and resize it to website. And then it will be in the format that I can easily just copy this whole section and add it into my website. All I need to do is paste it into a new section and then just adjust the design and adjust the section size, and we're good to go. So now the website is ready to publish. And of course, then preview your landing page or website by going to the preview button and just checking everything works well, it flows well. You can click through to any additional pages you've added, any links work well. Make sure that everything is in place before you publish it. But I do recommend to start with a template for Canva websites. You get this nice scrolling effect, and it's much easier to build out a website with a template to begin with. Before we publish our website, we want to preview it. Now, you can toggle between desktop, and it's very important you check how it views on a mobile as well. Canva's websites are responsive and work really well, but you may just want to double check all the sections are rendering well and everything looks as it should. Then you can come in to publish your website. You're given the option of using one of the generic site addresses, or it is also possible to set up a subdomain in your settings. But for the purposes of this video, let's keep it simple. We're just going to use one we can get up and running straight away. I'm just going to add Canva Lovers as part of my URL. And then all I have to do is check the address that we have there and then hit publish. Canva will then go ahead and publish the website, and it's all ready to go. And you can go and visit the website, check how it works, and obviously just check how it works on mobile and also on desktop. And you can go in and make edits and just republish it. So it's a really great way to get a website up and running. That's it for me. Let me know in the comments what gets you most excited about Canva websites, and try Canva websites today. Go to canva.com/website-builder to check out all of the information on this page. It has everything you need to get started with your free one-page Canva website, including loads of templates, all the features you need to access, examples for how to use them. Go check it out. If you like this video, please subscribe. It helps me to create more content for you. And check out the next video to create amazing visuals with Canva.